Well, these are really interesting ideas that we're revisiting.
Okay.
You know, and I think, like you said, you know, a lot of people might be taken back some by just, but it is kind of interesting that we have really strong ideas in our mind about things like heaven. But what you and I've been talking about is that it's surprising, really, how little scripture talks about heaven or what it's like or as a place that we go. And we have some images and ideas from scripture that we use, but it's those scriptures, for instance, like streets of gold or pearly gates, they're not really describing a place that we go. They're just describing, like you said, you know, heaven coming down to earth, the new Jerusalem. It was coming to earth, a new heaven and a new earth. So we come up with these ideas and we firmly fix them in our mind that this is what heaven is like and that's where I'm going when I die. And then we take things like Jesus said, you know, I go to prepare a place for you. And in our last conversation, you know, you mentioned that Jesus doesn't talk about a place that we go to. He mentions that in John 14, but he's not talking about going to a place called heaven to prepare a mansion for us or to prepare a place like that. But how do you hear or read what Jesus was saying when he said, I go to the Father to prepare a place for you?
Well, basically in that context there, the place that is used in the original Greek, and I won't give the Greek word, is sort of a temporary place, a lodging place. We might liken that to a modern day motel, which you may stay a few days, but then that's all that's involved. So that's not the final destination of the believer. And Jesus said that I'm going to prepare a place, and that place is in God's presence someplace. Again, it's not fully described. We can't put real words to it. If we use some metaphors or similes like it is in Revelation 21, 22, we can only put dimensions and understanding to it if we use concrete terms. But this is a spiritual dimension that we're talking about. And so we got to keep that in mind. We're talking about spiritual things. There's a place in God. There's a place in the Spirit. And we have given place to in Jesus by accepting him. And when he comes in, he establishes God's space within us. And so now he lives in us.
I like what you said, that it's a relational reality. So in John 14, Jesus says, I go to prepare a place for you, In the Father, I go to the Father's house to prepare a place for you. And then in John 15, Jesus says, abide in me and I in you. So Jesus, like you said, it's a spiritual reality that he's referring to. He's creating a relational space for us to abide in him, in the Father, so that we are entering into that Father-Son relationship with God that Jesus has. Jesus, that's the place he prepared for us. And we're to abide in that place. And when we abide in that relational reality that's in Christ, we're entering into heaven. And we don't have to wait until we die to do that.
And see, you spurred me on to think of something else.
That's good.
When it talks about your spiritual gifts. And your membership in the body of Christ. Everyone has a place in the body of Christ. And it's a spiritual place. It's not a literal physical place. It's a spiritual place. And Jesus is going to prepare that spiritual place for us. If we can stretch that analogy out a little bit. And at the end, we're going to enter into that spiritual place with great joy and thanksgiving because we're predestined and pre-conformed to be fulfilled only as we enter into the spiritual fulfillment of it and settle into that place of rest. And then there's righteousness, peace, and joy that just follows all of that as a result.
So he sets the members in the body as he wills,
That's
Right. That's 1 Corinthians 12. It's his sovereign choice, yeah. So he puts us in our place. And where is that place? In the body.
Right.
So in the body of Christ, we get put in the place that Jesus has made for us.
Right.
So when I find my place in Jesus, I experience heaven. I experience...
Right.
So you and I were talking off camera, and we were talking about how heaven is the place where God's rule and reign, or God's will, is just taking place, right? Yeah. So that's a great way for us to think about what is heaven. You know, maybe somebody's still holding on to the old and saying, well, I still believe heaven is a place. Well, if it is a place, then it's the place where God's rule, God's will, is happening without opposition. There's no, in other words, what God wants is what's happening.
Right.
But what you're saying is that we can yield ourselves to God's will, and then we experience heaven because we're living in a place where God's rule and God's reign is coming, and we're finding our place in Christ, in Jesus, in the body of Christ.
Yeah, that's very true. And when you do find your place and you accept the giftings that God has placed within you, accept the fact that God has created you for a specific assignment,
mm-hmm.
just like Adam and Eve were given a stewardship assignment over the whole earth.
Mm-hmm.
And God's intention was that place be where God and man could commune.
Yeah.
And God has not changed his mind about that.
Right.
So he wants us to enter into the place through salvation that he's established for us,
mm-hmm.
and begin a life of communion and fellowship, John 15,
yeah,
and become really fruitful, bearing fruit that will remain. And as we do that, at the end of life, he's going to say, well done, good and faithful servant, enter into the joys of the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, how do you describe joys? It's just something you can't put into words,
mm-hmm.
but you just know when you've arrived, everything's all right. My yeah. Father
right.
controls it all, and now he's going to receive his me, and he's going to love me because I'm fully accepted in the beloved.
Yeah. And so, like Psalm 16 says, you know, in the presence of the Lord,
fullness.
There's fullness of joy. And I think maybe a shift that you've made, you're encouraging people to make, is don't think of scriptures like that as for the yonder by and by after you die.
Right.
Think of them as an invitation to say, I can be in the presence of God right now, in the midst of my imperfect life and imperfect circumstances, and I can experience fullness of joy.
Yes.
That's heaven on earth.
And when you do that, you're fully human. That's okay. God's original intent.
Yeah.
If you reject that, you draw away from God, not accepting this gracious gift, and so you're moving further away from God.
Okay.
And so you're moving into sort of a hellish life.
Yeah.
Rather than to the abundant life.
Right. I like that.
You have life and that more abundant.
Yeah, pick that idea up. Let's pick that up in another conversation. I like that. Moving toward fully human, toward heaven reality, or moving away of a less human, hellish reality. We'll pick that up.